Now, one of the things that I love about WordPress and WooCommerce is that you can install them from scratch and you have your shop ready to go. So what I have here is I have Storefront theme installed, WooCommerce as a plugin on my WordPress, and I am able to have a cart that I can just actually click to add items, view the cart, and once I'm happy with that, I can actually just proceed to the checkout. Now, once I get here, I'm supposed to fill in all my different details, then my location, my street address, my village, district or state, and these are the fields that show on the checkout. Now, give or take, we have human error as we add all this information. What if you actually just had a Google map where you just click and add a little pin that would automatically fill all these fields for you and you would have a proper delivery from your shop? That would increase your sales, that would increase your store's viability, that would increase your customers' trust in having online orders. So how do we do this? This is what I'm going to show you in this video, as I found a very nice plugin that can actually do this for you. The plugin that I'm talking about is the location picker at checkout for WooCommerce, and this can be found on the WordPress.org plugin repository. And this is by Urias Victor, and it's a plugin that has a very well written documentation explaining everything that you need and how you can use the different pieces of the features that are embedded in this plugin. And since it's on the WordPress repository, it means it can be a free or a freemium kind of plugin. But right now you have so many features coming out of the box for free. So I would advise you to pick it up and then use it. Now I'm just going to copy this title because it's a bit long for me to remember and memorize. But you can just remember that it's the location picker at checkout for WooCommerce. So I'll go to the back end of my site. You'll see I only have WooCommerce installed. I'm going to click add new. I'll go in the search and I'll just paste the location picker checkout for WooCommerce. Hit enter to search and then it will come up. And right now this plugin has over 200 active installs. Now this is not the only installs that are being measured, but you have 200 people trusting the plugin. I'll hit activate. Now when this comes up, you have the option to allow and continue. That is for you to opt in to check for security, updates and so on, or you can choose to skip it. So you can also find out what permissions you're giving out by clicking this little link. So for now, I'm just going to allow and continue. And now we are ready to actually work with the plugin right here. So I'll go to WooCommerce, then I'll go to settings, and then I'll go to the location picker at checkout in this tab. And the plugin automatically gives you some guides that can help you to navigate through the whole challenge, and that's what I liked about this. So immediately you know that this particular plugin is going to use a Google API key and you need to create one. If you've never created a Google API key, the plugin already gives you the steps in the documentation. So by clicking on that link, you will see how you can actually create one. But I'm not going to just leave you the documentation. I'm going to show you how to do that in this very video. So right here, they tell you you need to go to the Google Cloud platform. We'll click that link and open it in a new tab. And the requirement for using the Google Cloud platform is that you need to have a Gmail account. Now, since the Gmail accounts are free and the Google Cloud platform is also free to a certain extent, you're given a number of credit dollars to start off with. And the reason is because the Google API is so popular, everyone would want to use it, but maintaining it with the servers and so on costs money. So Google gives you about 15,000 requests for free off the bat, and that's about $200 worth. But if you have a very busy shop, then I would advise you to pay so that you can have more requests than just 15,000. So the first thing we do when we get into the platform here is we're going to create a new project. So if you have not created a project before, you'll have a button here that tells you to create project. But since I have a few projects, I'm going to click here and then you'll click new project. And here I'll call this WooCommerce store. And then I'm going to click create. And once that's created, you're going to see that we're given a number of APIs in our particular project. Now for this very project, we're going to use the Places API and we're going to use the Maps JavaScript API. Those are two. It doesn't hurt if you enable all of them. I'll enable the Places API by clicking on it. Click enable. And that will provide us with over 100 million places available on our map. And that's one. Now next we need to click on the Maps JavaScript API. So I'll click on that. I'll hit enable. And you might be wondering why I'm looking for the Maps JavaScript API and the Places API. And that is because in our documentation, it tells us we need the Maps JavaScript API and the geocoding API. So I'm going to scroll all the way down and I'm going to add the geocoding API as well. I'll click enable. We've enabled three different APIs in here, but our plugin actually just needs only two of those, Maps JavaScript API and the geocoding API. We will be using the Places API in another feature of this very plugin. So if we have these two working, like we do right in here, we have the geocoding and the Maps API, we are good to go. So the next step would be for us to create credentials right here. So I'll click on the credentials in this left panel. Go ahead and click create credentials. And then I'll choose the API key because that's what we'll need. And then Google is going to automatically generate for us one right here. So I'll click this icon to just copy it and then close the button here. But we have this other button that says restrict the key. So we can be able to restrict our key to a particular domain or a mobile app. So that will reduce the likelihood that in case someone copied our key and they're trying to use it in their particular project, then they are not allowed to do so because we are paying for it maybe and we don't want our credits to run out. But for now, I'm not going to restrict the key. You can see how to do that in this documentation if you want to do that, but it's not necessary for me to do that because I'm going to delete it after this anyway. So I'll come back to my WordPress because I've created the key. I'll go into this portion. I'll add the new key right here. I will enable the map to appear on the checkout and in the order details. And then we have all these other options down here that I'll run you through. But for now, let's just turn on the housekeeping and say whenever we're deleting the plugin, we should remove all the plugin settings. And after doing that, I'll hit save changes here. And now we are ready. So I'm going to go back to my shop. I'll click this and say open in a new private window. And then I'm going to go to my shop. I'll click add to cart. I'll choose to view the cart to ensure that my order is correct. And then I'll hit the checkout button. And once I am here, you'll see that we have this new map showing up here. And it's saying the page cannot be loaded correctly. The best way to see what the problem is by going to inspect right here. Click on the console and you will have the message that shows you what's going on. So they tell us we need to enable this by adding a billing. So I'll just do that. I'll go and enable the billing. And once I sort out my billing issues, and now with this map, we can be able to add more settings to what we had before. So I'll go back to the backend. And inside here, we have the options where we can tell the map to detect the customer's location on the checkout page. I will leave this turned off because there could be some issues maybe in that particular area. You're not allowed to track IPs and so on. There's privacy issues all with that. I will leave this disabled. But also this can negatively impact the customer's experience as the plugin makes mention here. So I'll leave this off. I'm going to tell the plugin to force the use of the map, thereby making sure that the customer, and this will mean that the customer cannot check out until they have selected the location on the map. Remember that we want to make sure that we have the correct pin or the correct location for our delivery of our products. Now we also have the option to set the default coordinates. Let's say we're working in a local area, like in a small town, or just a few towns away, or even in a whole country, so we can set the coordinates right here. So let's say I'm going to say Kampala coordinates, and say Google Maps. So I'm just Googling this up, and I can just get these particular longitudes and latitudes. So I'll copy the latitude first, copy it, come and add it here, add a comma, then I'll get the longitude for my location. And you can do the same for yours, just separate them with a comma. I'll set the default zoom to about 15, which is good. So 10 to 15 is usually okay. Right here, it's recommended that I leave this disabled, but that means allow different things to be clicked on, but that could distract your customer. So we'll leave this disabled. We shall then turn on the autofill for the billing fields so that they come from the map. Then we shall also turn on or enable this field to show the map on the received order page. Enable this to show the map on the view order page. We shall also allow the map to be shown in the emails, and we shall leave it as a button. Let's save this. So after adding all these particular settings, I'm going to go to my store. I'll open up in a new private window, so that I don't have to log out of my admin, but I want to be able to test to make sure this is working. I'll then go to the shop. I'll add what item. I'll choose to view the cart to make sure that my order is safe. It is what I need. Then I'll click proceed to checkout. And with this, I now have a new map showing up here. I'll click to detect the current location. And that is going to give me this little red marker right here. This marker can be moved to any other location. I can move out of my map, go to another location, keep going into the specific part, and then I can hit all the way to a building level. And once I'm done with that, you'll scroll down and you'll see that all these different pieces have been actually filled out for you. So this is what we needed on our map. It's giving us the right details. It's giving us everything down to granular level. So let's say I wanted to change this location. It wasn't the correct one. I can change that. This will give it a little bit of a reload. And you'll see that we get something that's really, really new right here. So this is brilliant. This is what we need for our maps. This is what we need to make sure that we are getting the correct information. So once I'm done filling in, let's say these areas, so I'll just fill in this last area, fill in my email. So once I've filled in all this information, I can actually click place order. And you'll see that now my order comes up here. It has also the map showing the location, which I pinned right on here. And my order is as good as it should have been. So I'm going to go into the administration area, and I'm going to go into the orders, just to show you what that looks like. And if I go to this particular order, which just came in a few seconds ago, you'll see that in this section, we also have a delivery map showing the location that was selected by the customer. So of course, this will mean that we're going to get the right place. We're going to be able to make the delivery order. You'll see that the billing is in the right place. So this is good to go. So this is a very nice implementation that you can use on your shop to make sure that you're having good deliveries and you're having your customers happy. Now there is one more setting here which we can use, and it's called the Enable Places Autocomplete feature. And this one will allow you to just type in, as you're typing in a name of a place, it will allow you to type and get the correct address. And once we click this particular piece, you'll see that we get this new field that asks us to add the input field where we want this to happen. So I'll click on the billing address, hide the map when we're using the autocomplete. So I'll say yes and hit save changes here. So I'll open up our store again after saving those settings. So once we've saved those settings, ensuring that we're going to have an autocomplete, I'll go to visit my store again in a private window. I'll choose a few items on sale by clicking add to cart. I'll quickly run out, go check out, And on the checkout page, you're going to realize that we have our items in the cart. However, we don't have the map showing up right here. So what I'm going to do is just add my little information. I'll just add a fake name. I'll add the country there. But as I go to the street address and begin to type, let's say 41, you'll see that I get all these options showing up and I can be able to choose this for my country. So I can fit this information right here. And you'll see that this all gets thrown into the right fields. And since this information is already there, all we need to do is just fill in all the other information that's missing, then we can be able to place our order. So I'll just quickly do this, add simple information here, I'll add an email, and then what I'm going to do at the end of the day is just place my order, and my order will be received. So it is important for us to know that if we want to use the autocomplete, then we need to have the Places API installed. That's why in the first case when I was setting up my Google account, I added the Places API. And that's where we're using it with this particular feature. Now, depending on the version of the plugin that you're using, it will be important for you to go and check out, are there any other APIs that I need to do A, B, C, D? For example, as of now, you can actually have a map showing up inside your order as an admin. And that is based on a different API that we've not installed in this particular plugin. So as the plugin is changing and evolving, I'm pretty sure they'll be able to use all the different APIs that are available on Google. So it is important for you to actually go and check out the documentation, find out, is there any API that I need to install for a particular feature X? And when you do that, then you'll have it just working out fine as it is intended to be. So if you're planning on using this plugin, don't forget to leave the publisher or the author of it a comment by just going to the plugin section. You can go and check out the view details pin inside here. Visit the homepage on the WordPress repo. Leave a comment, leave a suggestion. Look at the documentation, see something that will help the plugin make it better for you and for others that will use it. Of course, leave a rating depending on how you found it. Otherwise, I really enjoyed using this particular plugin and it's making my shop work much, much better. Otherwise, thank you for watching the video and enjoy whatever you're developing.